forward, telling
listen up, son. Check it out, though. Hey, yo, open your eyes, get wise and look alive. Focus your attention. Windows 95, updated, high tech, glinching. Cautious of the colored man who claim he owes the keys to the safe. Secrets of the world, blow him in his face. Who's the master of the universe? Galaxy and planets, Babylonians, the static moon, the sinking of Atlantis.
Be the one, soul originals, black filled with melanin. Going out like rebels in Kuwait in 2000.
Hear my synopsis, I drop this. Generates thoughts upon awareness of the here and now. Building upon with many spirit now. Society and flaws, unjust laws remain devoid of common cause. Equality rules you to love that equality. Many's lord to trust this. Act of the devil, possess the sword of justice. Take the devil's head through levels in bed. Truth to spread to mental death.
Imagine us traveling back to Nazareth.
Most fabulous.
To raise up the black dead slaves like Lazarus.
With our chests raised through the blaze, holy essays. No more death days of vex slaves possessed in caves.
It's the last day of the time, we got to raise your mind. Brothers walk around dumb, deaf, and they blind.
Shalom, shalom, Yisrael, Hebrews and Shebrews. It's your brother Mikael Ben Israel coming at you with another Hebrews and the His Hood from the crib. I was checking out brother, shout out to brother Israel Doctrine, Carl Albert. He did a show on Africa Bambaataa and the new anniversary they got coming up for hip hop. That's about to go down. I don't remember the date. Y'all can go check his YouTube channel and get all that information or whatever. But I got to give a shout out to the brother because I was just thinking about this, you know. I was listening, like, yeah, I'm listening to the old school, man, you know, I like listening to the old school, you know, where hip-hop come from and all that, and I remember I was listening to Planet Rock, man, one day, I think it was Planet Rock, it's one of Africa Bambaataa them songs, man, and I used to really like that song, and I don't even feel right listening to it. Y'all know the story, Africa Bambaataa has been accused of molesting a lot of people, a lot of little boys in particular. Girls too, I believe. And, you know, on Israel's show, he was basically saying how he basically pushed the envelope on it. He ain't let up on it. But other people, it's like a fad. They'll speak on it and then for whatever reason, they just act like it never happened. So now they're having this big anniversary and you know, it's funny because it's like, how many people going to really go support that, though? So this is a video, man, where I'm going to talk to the so-called conscious community. And the conscious black community, quote unquote. Because y'all can't be hypocrites, and that's what y'all are. Y'all talk about the Catholic Church and other religious organizations who sweep pedophilia, child molestation and gay perversion under the rug, but y'all do it too. Matter of fact, y'all don't even really sweep it under the rug. It happens and just nothing happens about it. Like, y'all is cool with it. Then y'all wonder why Hebrew Israelites, whenever we they debate Kemetics or Nubians or anybody of that pan-African, you know, Northeast African, because that's really what it is, concept, why the Hebrew Israelites always bring up acts of homosexuality in their history and all those things. Some people might just be nitpicking because they probably just don't know how to deal with the information, but I know as far as me and my constituents, that's no problem. Information is no problem. You find out a lot of people that talk about these concepts as if they deeper than the Holy Bible and the scriptures and stuff, they really don't know what they're talking about. When you go look at it, they don't know the history that they're claiming. You know what I'm saying? I know a lot of Hebrews that attack cats up and now Valley history and all of that. But that's not the point, because I'm not trying to isolate a particular group of people. Because it's one thing, though, if you ever notice, I'm not saying it don't exist, but for the most part, you don't really hear about no homosexuality in the Hebrew Israelite community, like within the camps and stuff of that nature. You heard of people who were reformed sodomites, you know, whether you even believe that's possible or not, it's people who lived a gay lifestyle and they feared the Lord and they turned their life over. So that's a good thing, because that is a cancer in our community too. We don't like to talk about it. We like to get politically correct when it comes to that. You know what I'm saying? We like to say, man, you know, whatever they do in their bedroom, that don't bother me. Yes, it do. Because a lot of you got a lot of down low cats acting like they just like females, and they go around sleeping with another with a female, and they got a little boyfriend in the closet. And we so messed up morally that it ain't no more, you know, I can't even think of the word for it. But it's no limitations in our community sexually nowadays. You know, the quote unquote African American community, which is I believe is truly the Lost Tribes of Israel community. We always was called the most homophobic community. Homophobic. I hate that term too, because that means you scared of homos. Ain't nobody scared of them. We just detest it, because God detests it. But now it's like it ain't no limits. Everybody don't want to offend nobody, right? But they'll talk about murderers. They even talk about child molesters, but they won't talk about homosexuals, because they say it's two consenting adults. Well, if we don't have laws, statutes, and morals that's in the Bible in our community, then you don't see people preaching monogamy. That's the word I was looking for, monogamy. So people just sleeping around. So if you sleeping around with some people that's sleeping with the same sex and don't know it, and then you catch stuff like HPV, you know, from brothers getting bacteria in their penis, right, from having anal sex. And, you know, it lays dormant. It don't affect the male. But then when they have vaginal sex with a female, it can set up, most studies say it can set up cervical cancer within a half a year, 6 months, 6 to 8 months. So that is a problem for our community. Y'all need to stop with that. But back on this conscious community cast. So Africa Mbata supposedly, and I'm just saying allegedly just because I don't really know, but I have heard people for sure come on and say that they was touched. I'm not calling y'all liars. It's just for legal reasons, because I know this stuff go on. And, you know, so he raped all these little boys and girls. And, you know, it's like ain't nothing happening to him. It's like, you know what I'm saying? And I ain't saying go do nothing violent to him, but definitely don't feed his pockets. Don't give him no admiration. You know what I'm saying? So I mean that's backwards. You know? So you can't talk about the Catholic Church and all that type of stuff when y'all doing the same thing. Like real talk. Y'all doing the same thing. Yeah, y'all don't laugh at my throwbacks, man. I'm in one of the relaxed moods. Even though it's a serious situation, I'm just cool about it. Because rather I'm screaming and yelling to the top of my lungs, it ain't going to make this message, you know, less important. So, you know, they got to hide this thing, the hip-hop, whatever, Africa been bothering them because they like the pioneers of hip-hop. But they also pioneers of molesting little boys in the community. And I was looking at a statistic, man. The statistics can go either here or there depending on who take them. But I kind of believe it. It's a 1 in 3 females, and I believe this was just in our community, are molested, you know, 1 in 3 as children. And it was 1 in 5 in boys. Now, the scary thing about that, when it comes to males being molested, it don't get spoke about. Like, maybe if they was molested, maybe if they was molested by a female, you might hear about it, because, you know, the way society set up, females can't really do nothing wrong when it comes to children. You know what I mean? Which is retarded, because you got some freaky, perverted women out here too. But especially if it's a male doing it to a male, because, you know, looking at it, some will say, you know, they'll probably feel like, you know, that's embarrassing. You know, some playing with your manhood before you even a man. So I know the reasons a lot of males wouldn't come out and speak about that. That's why I got respect for that brother Hassan Campbell for being able to come out and speak on what he spoke on, what happened to him. That's the brother Poppy. Y'all know him, after my bottom molested him and Savage, and it was like a number of people that came out and said it. What's the other brother that's like his son? Say his two sisters were molested. I'm sorry, brother, I can't remember your name, but I think it's David York. No, matter of fact, it was Malachi York molested him. See, and that's the thing. Malachi York, who starts this new YBN movement thing, you know, said he was about 7,000 years. I used to listen to his tapes back in the day, like when I first came into the truth that I was Israelite. You know, you just be testing, checking out stuff. And being that I understood New Wabians was used to be called, they used to call themselves Nubian Islamic Hebrews. Yeah, Nubian Islamic Hebrews is all wrapped up into a funky ball. And with some comedic science in it, because they say all that comes from Kemet or whatever. But I ain't here to dispute that right now. But the thing is, I used to listen to him, and I know he used to say some real spiritually retarded stuff. But I see how he can suck people in, because our people gullible. If it sound different, it's true. If it sound anything far off from the Holy Bible, which they've labeled and deemed the white man's book, which just simple history lets you know, they went through hell to let us know black people didn't write that book. Black people wrote that book, and that book is about black people, you know. And, but like I say, I ain't here to dispute that either. I'm just throwing that out there. And so I used to listen to him. You know, he said some crazy stuff. He said some stuff that made sense. But it all came out, he made most of that stuff up, and he took little parts. You can go back and look yourself, you know. It's old white dudes that came up with theories back in the 60s, 50s, 40s, 70s, 80s. And he was just taking little parts of it and slapping it all together and coming up with his own story. You know, like Nibiru and Planet with Giants on it coming and all type of stuff that you can find in other authors and stuff. So he really didn't, you know, it wasn't nothing divine about it. He just played off the gullibleness of people. But while him doing it, his philosophy wouldn't have been a problem, you know, if it was helpful. But he was using that power to abuse our children. And if you see, hopefully it should be up there. I'm having some editing problems later, but when this video came on, you should have seen those scriptures up there. While Mashiach, the Messiah, Jesus Christ, was saying, you know, how bad it is to offend a little one, you know, children. And it has a spiritual meaning to it, too, because when we come in the world, we're supposed to be like little kids. But this is the deep part, because even on the literal side, even on the metaphysical, symbolic side, whatever you want to call it, it is quite relevant what it's saying. A child from the ages of 1 to 3, I believe, and somewhere in that window, I say 1 to 6, but I believe it's like within 1 to 6, between 3 and 5, a child is most impressionable, meaning they like a magnet, they like a sponge. Everything they learn, they just suck up, right? So if a child that age is being molested, abused, what you think they sucking up? They gonna take that with them as they grow into the community. So that goes back to what I was saying with the statistics with the one out of every 5 black males are molested, and they can't tell nobody because they don't want their image on them as a man, even though they didn't have nothing to do with it because they was children. You know, they're going to act out violently. And I would be real curious into what the statistics is. If somebody can drop them on how many violent offenders and the institutions have been molested. And it's obvious what it does with the sisters. I'm checking my playlist right here, so y'all gonna see. Yeah, I can get real dusty. And don't think I can listen. I listen to some update stuff too, but most of that just sound retarded. But so I'd rather just oh man, Mary Jane girls. So yeah, look, right, you know, somebody needs to check that out. I wasn't surprised at how it is. Like I say, it's obvious what it do with the females. You know, they become sexually loose. You know what I'm saying? Because during a stage of innocence, they already being played with. And so with a little boy, if a female do it, he just ain't gonna have no respect for women when he grow up. He don't think they just for sex, or he gonna think he's only for sex. So he ain't really have no respect for a woman, you know. And if it's a male doing it to him, he gonna think that's natural sex. And they go to homosexuality being repeated. Or there's a lot of males, I believe, that was molested. Like, you know, some of the brothers that I mentioned, I haven't heard anything of them having an alternative lifestyle. So they look like regular dudes. I'm pretty sure they are regular dudes. So they're going to act out violently because they hate what happened to them. You know what I'm saying? They might be gay bashers when they, you know, when these little boys grow up. And you can understand why. So if we don't address homosexuality, when you got to be a homosexual as a man to play with a little boy. So one level of evil graduates to another level of evil. So y'all need to stop with that. You know, it was even some, now, like I said, I've never heard of it in the Hebrew Israelite community as far as on the homosexual side, because it's straightforward laws against that. You know, you ain't got to go chisel no pyramids and flip over text just to go find it. It's there, obviously, over and over again. If you want to say homophobic, then the Bible is homophobic. You know what I'm saying? And so if they doing it in the Hebrew Israelite community, it's definitely in the closet. Now, what you have seen is pedophilia, though. We ain't immune to that. You know what I'm saying? I can't remember exactly which one of them cult leaders, you know, they call all of us a cult. That don't bother me, but this was a cult. But I'm not going to say his name because I'm not sure it's him, so I don't bear false witness on nobody. But I remember it was them, one of these brothers that's supposed to have been a messiah or something, was accused of playing with a bunch of little girls. You know what I'm saying? And so that level of perversion is even there. But just straight out freaky, nasty, gay, which is just as bad, that you really don't see that. But like I said, not exempt, because the perversion is there. Anytime you want to deal with a little girl instead of a grown woman, it must have something to do with your mentality. One, you sick for being attracted to something that little. And two, you must just don't want to deal with a grown woman because it's a power thing. You weak. And I'm telling y'all, if y'all listening to it, go get you some help because you weak. And I know, Lord, the vengeance is in the Lord's hand and all that. But me being a brother from the streets, I still got that in me a little bit. You know, I'm working on it. But when it comes to stuff like that, I have absolutely no leniency towards you. You're playing with little kids, boys or girls, you need a brick shower. Now, the thing is, I wouldn't want to go to jail for it, but I couldn't sit around counsel. And I know as a priest of the Most High, I'm supposed to be able to counsel anybody in their conditions, you know, coming up out of sin. But I can't deal with no child molesters, man, no rapists and all that type of stuff. I can't do that. You know what I'm saying? Because it's an evil, it's an evil on top of evil, yo. So I made this video just to say, you know, we need to stop playing games, man. So I'm feeling Brother Carl and everybody else that's on these airways blasting these perverts, because that's what they are, conscious community perverts. And if you still follow them and try to clean it up and all that type of stuff, man, don't come around us real cats. As we said in Hebrew Israelite community, Jakes, you know, from our father Jacob, so-called Negro, we can't be around our real Jakes, man, trying to sugarcoat that stuff. Them children is defenseless, man, like real talk. And so if you support that, man, you weak. Straight up, you weak for whatever reason you're doing it, financially or you emotionally tied to these predators. That's your damn problem. I don't care if it's your father or whatever. You can love your father like that brother Tazariak said. You can love your father, Prince York. But you can say, man, he was wrong. Because ain't no way on earth, man, you going to admit to the guilt. You know, he admitted that he did it in a court of law. Can't nobody get me to admit nothing. I mean, if this man had all these thousands of years of wisdom, how he ain't know they was tricking him to do that? How he know what you thought they was going to let you out because you admitted it? I thought you'd come from another galaxy or your knowledge was passed down by an alien. I don't even remember what he said he got his knowledge from. But I know, you know, he was talking about how you can astro travel and and change the density of your body. I remember hearing him say on one of them videos a long time ago in the 90s. I think I heard him say something like that, early 2000s, late, no, mid-90s or something. But, you know, he's still sitting in a jail cell. Why he ain't materialized through one of them walls and come up out of there? Y'all need to stop with the foolishness. Y'all want to talk about us believing in the Bible. Everything that went on in the Bible, man, for the most part, we can see it today. You know, other than the miraculous things that the Most High did. And you still, you know, have occasions of them things happening also. His hand ain't got short. But I ain't seen no Negroes that ain't angels, ain't spirits walking through no walls. So how y'all even believe that and ain't seen it happen shows you stupid. Like, straight up. So if you could believe that, it's pretty sure you can deny the fact that somebody has been a predator amongst you. And you just want to turn a blind eye. So I said that just to say, man, before you could try to point at somebody else. Oh, and one more thing. So that was the serious stuff. And I think I heard something about what's the brother, Professor X from X-Clan. He was messing with little girls or something. You know, if I'm wrong, forgive me. But I heard something like that on a couple of videos a few days ago. And like I said, I'm just lambacking backing off the brother Carl Albert. Stance that he making, because you know we don't piggyback because we Hebrews. So I land back up off that there, you know, because it do need to be said, and we should put it on every airway. What y'all scared of? The LGBT community, you know, I already think they in cahoots with the conscious community anyway. Like that brother Josh put that video out, y'all need to check it out, about the gay conscious community agenda or something like that, with the got the eye Haru on it. Everybody want to talk about. I understand. You see him on Facebook. I with eyeball instead of I. Come on, man. You ain't deep. That's gay satanic witchcraft. So, again, whether y'all believe it or not, I have friends that's from other concepts. You know, comedic, all that. You know, just because, you know, Bruce and the comedics be banging on each other. I know some brothers that don't get down like them. That's just the concept that they believe in. So this ain't got nothing to do with them, because a real cat going to be a real cat. Cat. But what we're trying to say, and people like me, is the Hebrews, our concept, the Most High, we believe in is spirits. Once you let that spirit stay amongst you, some people call it, other cultures call it concepts or energy or whatever. Same thing. The only difference is they want to take credit away from the Father of spirits, which is the Most High. But once you let that spirit sit around, it festers. It festers and it eats the body up like a cancer, and the body being the people. Like we in a body of Christ. And so with that, man, I just had to make this short video and throw that out there to y'all, man. Thanks for everybody that's supporting the videos. Thanks for the positive feedback. And I'm just winging this thing out, man, till I can get Walls of Jericho back playing like I wanted to. Some things happened really all on my part. So I apologize for that. But it will be coming in God's due time. And be on lookout. I am still working on my book. You know, from a servant of the Lord, or well, from vice lord to servant of the Lord. Real grimy, real life book. That's going to tell my walk. So y'all be on the lookout for that too. Again, subscribe to Hebrews in the Hood, and even my Mikael Yisrael channel, if you don't mind. It's sitting over there kind of lonely, but I might start putting something on there too. So with that, I say, like the brother Cesariak and them had that Make Atlanta Straight Again convention or whatever. Make the conscious community straight again. I told y'all, Yaknam, I told y'all, I said, man, Joe, I'm thinking about getting some shirts made. Make the conscious community straight again. Because there's a lot of closet gay stuff going on. That's why they so quick. They get upset if you talk about homosexuality. Like, you can talk about everything else but homosexuality. And then they try to flip it on you. Talk about it so much. You know, you must be. No, no, no. Y'all defend it so much. You must. Got something going on with the sugar. I've never seen that. Like, they don't defend murderers, rapists, nothing. But when it come to that, oh, don't talk about that. You're, you know, like the brother Garfield be saying, Dagger Squad, you're a baddieologist. I used to think that was funny. But, you know, they start saying it too much. I'm like, come on, dude. Damn, you can't even talk about it. There's something ain't right about that. Ain't saying nothing wrong with that, brother. I ain't going to do him like that. You know what I'm saying? He a man. But I'm just saying, y'all, it don't look right. Keep defending homosexuality, but you would talk about everything else. That's real suspect, especially for people who got intelligence. who can do all this studying and research, but you ain't got enough intelligence to know homosexualities have always been a moral, physical, and medical parasite in our community, just draining us, because it ain't nothing positive in it whatsoever. Especially the closet ones, like I said, they sleeping with women. Y'all don't believe in, you know, people that ain't strong on marriage like us with a spiritual background, you know, so y'all just sleeping around. So you just passing around booty diseases and taco eating diseases and all that type of stuff. You know what I'm saying? So with that, I say thanks for tuning in. Shalom, shalom. Grace and peace in Jesus. Peace.
Shalom, shalom.